If you are new to CCS, you will hear a number of different terms being used related to our shared software and tools. It's important to understand what these terms mean or are referring to. Let's take a few minutes to define some that you will encounter frequently throughout these training courses. First, CCS libraries use the Polaris Integrated Library System, or ILS. When you hear staff mention Polaris, they are referring to our shared database. This database contains all of the information on CCS library items, patrons, transactions, and more. It also contains all the necessary settings and data that allows libraries to perform essential functions like checking out or processing new materials. Depending on your role in the library, you will either be working in LEAP or the staff client. LEAP is the Polaris web-based application. This means that it can be accessed and used on any computer, tablet, or device with an internet connection. All you need is a browser and a login. LEAP is mainly used by public services staff. The staff client is the Polaris desktop application. Unlike LEAP, the staff client needs to be downloaded and installed on your computer. This application is mostly used by technical services staff since it includes functions for cataloging and acquisitions that LEAP just doesn't quite have yet. The Power Pack is the Polaris online catalog. PACK stands for Public Access Catalog. This is the tool patrons use when searching for titles at home or at the library's catalog stations. You may hear staff refer to the online catalog as the Power Pack or simply as the Pack. In addition to these tools, you will also hear the terms production database and training database. You have access to two different versions of the Polaris database. One is the production database or the live database. This is the version you will be using when working with patrons at your library. You also have access to a training database, or a training version of Polaris. Just as its name suggests, staff can access this version of Polaris if they need an environment for training or testing. This version is not live, meaning any activity, including checkouts, check-ins, or updates to records, are not reflected in a patron's actual account. We will be working in the training version of Polaris during these courses. When using LEAP, there's a couple ways you can tell you're using the training version. First, make sure you see training in the URL. Second, when logging in, an alert will tell you when the data was last synced with the production database. One thing to keep in mind here is that when working in training LEAP, the data will likely be outdated. Don't worry if you see old checkouts on your record. Finally, once you're logged in, you'll see the banner in Training LEAP is red instead of the standard blue banner. Thanks for watching. In the next video, we'll show you how to log in and out of LEAP.